Hello guys, assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to another video. So today I have going into more detail on these foods, these new foods I've tried not that long ago, maybe last week, and I've fallen in love with them ever since. They're so delicious. And I know a lot of you from the West watching me probably have never heard of this. I have never heard of this before. If you have, you know, if you're from the regions that makes this wonderful food and you know what it is, please feel free to comment. But as you saw in the opening there, this is jarish. This is jarish. And this here is called ash. And this is some wheat bread. Like, they make it fresh every day, all the time. So basically, as you saw, I wanted to show you guys, I told Salah to film for me when he ran in to get the food. They have these big vats and they cook these foods inside for a long time and then they serve it up. That's traditionally how they do it. And sometimes they also cook them in like these big clay pots. Jarish, in case you're wondering, is a cracked wheat. It's jarish just means cracked wheat, like wheat. And it's wheat in its whole form, so it's not stripped. It's full of fiber and phytonutrients. It's a staple Kuwaiti dish. And there's also in other countries, it's made in other countries, like in Saudi Arabia. It's basically like a savory porridge. Yes, you can have savory porridge. It doesn't have to be sweet, but it's made with cracked or crushed wheat in its whole form. So it has the whole wheat germ and everything. And Arabic spices, tomato, and this is made with chicken. So you can see little chunks of chicken in there. And it's so delicious and savory and yummy, and I love it. So this is like a Persian dish, and it's made with beans, chickpeas, lentils, onions, spices, a bunch of herbs, and there's spinach, a lot of spinach in there. I love it. And of course I have some pickles. So I'm just gonna eat a little bit with you guys to show you. But yeah, I just wanted to show you guys one of my new favorite dishes here, a couple of them, and definitely for one is the jarish. So you eat it with bread like that, bismillah, and they cook it for so long until it becomes like a creamy texture on the ash. But traditionally ash has Persian style noodles in it, but this has no noodles. It's just such a healthy, delicious comfort food. Pickle fork, water. Now this meal will keep you full for a long time. It's full of protein, healthy fibers. I love how unprocessed the food is. Coming from a place where there's so much processed food, like even in the grocery stores here, you won't find highly processed packaged foods, canned meals. There's canned vegetables, sure. This is made with boneless chicken. You can also make it with boneless meat, which is very popular, but I could eat this like every day. It's super affordable. Like, for a huge bag of this fresh bread, there's a place that just makes bread in like a big oven. Like a big bread oven. And they just pump out bread, and it's 100 fills for a big bag of like 5 or 6 breads that are like this big. And they're non-processed. Like I said, the wheat germ is still intact. You can see it. And it's 100 fills, which is for like about 45 cents, I think. So it's very affordable. This, for a container like this each, and one container like this will last me 3 meals, is 400 fills each. So that's about $1.50, $1.30 American, about $1.70 Canadian. I thought it would be cool to show you guys like some kind of, you know, I always talk about how the food is cheap and there's like, you know, a lot of ethnic food. That's so good. I love Kuwait. I get excited about, you've seen me get excited about unhealthy takeout, but I also get excited about healthy, real, unprocessed food that tastes like comfort food. I love it. And more pickle. If you love spinach, you're gonna love that. You're gonna love the ash. If you love beans, lentils, see the lentils and beans. Turmeric, anti-inflammatory turmeric. You know, food is, it's so rich in culture. And it really interests me, like the different foods they have in different countries, because usually there's so much culture surrounding it. And you can learn so much. Thank God for good food. Usually freeze the leftover bread, but it's very fresh. So, you know, if you don't freeze it, it'll never be the same. There's no preservatives, right? When you buy loaves of bread, like Wonder Bread, That can last for a long time. It's like weird how long it can last. But if you have fresh bread with no preservatives, you can tell because it goes hard the next day. So you have to really preserve the bread. But it's never the same as when it's fresh. Right out of the oven. It's like there's just a small building that just does bread. And you just see people lining up. So, and for 45 cents for a bag, you can't beat that. You can't. Anyways, guys, I just wanted to share with you this wonderful meal. If there's any of you who are from Kuwait and want me to try any kind of restaurant, any kind of different cuisine, it's very multicultural here when it comes to food. And I'll tell you, the majority so far that I've seen, Kuwaiti, Gulf country food, Afghani food. This restaurant's run by an Afghani person, Saudi Arabian. There's a huge Indian population here, so there's a lot of Indian run restaurants, Indian restaurants. there's a huge Filipino population, so there's a lot of Filipino food. I gotta take you guys to the Filipino areas where there's restaurants and things. There's a lot of, I've never tried like authentic Filipino food before, so there's a lot of Persian food. Iranian? There's so many places, and I have to tell you, they make the best kebab. I swear, it's so delicious. And there's a lot of Syrian restaurants. In my opinion, they make the best shawarma, and I love the makluba. There's a lot of Lebanese food. So there's just like, it's just very multicultural. So they do have a huge Western influence as well. They have a lot of restaurants, like, you know, they have Texas Roadhouse, they have a Chili's, they just have a ton of American restaurants. But what interests me the most is the more ethnic food, homemade food. So that's where it's at. That's where it's at. I mean, I've had burgers and fries for days when I was in Canada. I could, whenever, you can always get a burger, but you can't always have gyrish unless you're in the Middle East or you find like a niche restaurant somewhere. I hope you found this video a bit interesting, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. Anyway, I'm gonna go. Just wanted to chit chat, make a video, and yeah, I guess I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.